Hey guys, so we're going to continue our series about fertilizer calculations. If you missed the last video, we talked about calculating granular fertilizer, and based on the label rate, you know, how do you know how many pounds per thousand square foot you're actually getting in that bag? So I showed you the math to help figure that out, as well as the math to figure out how to adjust that application rate if you want to do, say, a half a pound, three quarter pound, 1 pound of nitrogen per thousand. And how does that determine how many bags of the product you actually need? So if you didn't already check that one out, I encourage you to go watch that one. But in this one, we're going to continue our talk about calculating liquid fertilizer, because liquid fertilizer is a little bit of a different ball game. If you look at the labels on liquid fertilizer bottles, they'll say, you know, use 8 to 16 ounces per thousand square foot. But how do you know how many pounds of nitrogen per thousand square foot you're actually getting? So I'm going to show you the math behind all that to help you understand how to adjust your rate of ounces to based on how many square foot you have to help you determine how many pounds of nitrogen per thousand you're actually getting. Because with liquid applications, since it's a foliar application, foliar absorbed through the plant, you tend to do applications in lower rates. So for example, I'll do an eighth rate maybe every week, quarter rate every 2 weeks. And sometimes you might want to do a half a rate per thousand. Just depends on what part of the season you're in. And so I'll step you through the math. So with that, let's continue our series talking about liquid fertilizer applications. All right, so let's switch gears for a minute and let's talk about liquid fertilizer applications. And for this example, I went ahead and brought out the next product of the green punch, which is their 1801. Because I talked about this product a little bit in a previous video, and so here I wanted to explain that a little further on why I got some of the results that I got on this. When we talk about liquid fertilizer can be a little bit scary, because if you add too much liquid, you can very easily fry your lawn really quick if you're not careful, and if you don't understand the math and you don't understand what it is you're doing. Because liquid applications are a little different than like weed applications, where, you know, when you buy the bottle of weed killer at the store, it'll say, you know, so many ounces per gallon of water. Well, it doesn't work that way quite with like fertilizer and fungicides and herbicides in a bigger format. The way that's geared toward is you need so much product to cover so many acres, and it's all about how much water is in your tank. So it doesn't matter how much water is in your tank as long as you get the right amount of product sprayed out. So they use the term water as a carrier. And so basically, you know, I can put 4 gallons of water in my tank to cover this 2,000 square foot area here, or I can put 8 or 10 gallons of water, 2,000 square foot area. But as long as I get all the product down that I've mixed into that tank into this area, it's covered. So that's why the word carrier is important in liquid applications. It's a little different than, like I said, where you've got a pump sprayer and you're doing, you know, so many ounces per gallon of water. This doesn't work that way. So that's why I want to help you understand the math here, because nobody ever talks about the math. They just say, oh, well, the label says, oh, it just put in eight ounces per so many thousand square feet or whatever, but they don't talk about, well, how do you figure out what that is? Like, how much nitrogen am I actually getting in 8 ounces of this product? I'm gonna help you understand that math. I'm gonna help break it down. It's easy to understand once you've done it a couple of times, but it's something you've really gotta understand if you wanna be effective and not be worried about burning your lawn. And so on any liquid fertilizer, somewhere on the label, you're gonna find a little stamp that tells you how much 1 gallon of this product weighs, okay? And I'm not talking about the entire jug. Okay, I'm talking about how much a gallon of this product weighs. They all are a little different because of different NPK values, different micros they might have inside this jug, so it changes the weight and the chemistry of how much is in that gallon. So this particular product, so the classic 1836, it weighs 10.58 pounds per gallon, okay? So that's the number we've got to start with, is 10.58. And this is an 1836 on the NPK. So you're going to take 1 gallon, so 10.58, you're going to multiply that times 0.18, okay? And that's going to give you a number of 1.9044 pounds of nitrogen, okay? So there is 1.9044 pounds of nitrogen in 1 gallon of this product, okay? So what we need to get that down to is we've got 1.90044
pounds in a gallon. I've got to get that broken down into ounces because we do applications in ounces, right? So to do that, you take your 1.9044. I know this is going to be a crazy math lesson, but you divide that by 128 ounces. There's 128 ounces in a gallon of liquid. And so that's going to give you a value of 0.048 per ounce. That's how much nitrogen you get in 1 ounce. So if you look at the label, okay, it says to apply, you know, 8 ounces per thousand square foot. What that means is you're going to take that value of 0.0148. So there's 0.0418 pounds of nitrogen in 1 ounce. And we're going to do 8 ounces. So multiply that times 8. That's going to give me 0.119. So if you think about that, that's real close to 0.128. So that means you're going to be putting down an eighth of a pound of nitrogen per thousand square foot. Have I lost you already? I know, it's crazy. But once you've done this math before and you kind of step through it, it all makes sense. It makes perfect sense, actually. That's how you figure out how much am I applying at 8 ounces per thousand, how much is 16 ounces per thousand. So in this case, 16 ounces per thousand square foot is going to give me a quarter pound of nitrogen per thousand square foot. And that's real common in liquid applications. You're going to be applying this stuff at lower rates because it's a foliar application. It works different than granular does. It's more instantaneous. And so a lot of times what I do is I get my yard kickstarted with a quarter rate. And then with this product, because it's 50% SRN, that's slow release nitrogen, because of that fact, I'm able to then spoon feed it every couple of weeks with an eighth rate. So think about that. You know, I'm only using 8 ounces of this 2.5 gallon jug per thousand ever so many weeks. So this jug lasts me all season. Whereas if I go buy, you know, granular fertilizer, I go through bags and bags of that stuff throughout the year. So liquid is by far the way to go to save money on your lawn. Now I realize some of you guys are like, yeah, but the spray equipment costs so much money. Yeah, it does. It's expensive, but it's worth the investment because within a season, you've got that paid for. And for some of you guys that have really large properties, you'd have that paid for within an application or two of your yard, and you'll have better results. Don't be afraid to go with the liquid application because, yeah, I understand there's some cost to it. And there's more upfront cost with buying this jug versus buying a few bags of fertilizer, but this lasts me all season long. And that's how we calculate it. I want to talk about this next product line a little bit, because in my last, not the last video, but the last one I spoke about fertilizer, I mentioned to you guys that I didn't quite get the results that I was expecting with this product. And I now understand why a little bit more than I did. I want to talk to you guys more about this. So this is a Green Punch 1801, okay? And again, I'm going to say it up front. I am not saying anything negative about Green County Fertilizer. I do think what they're doing is great. I think they've got good products. But I am not getting the results that I would expect on my lawn with this product. And that's why I went back to this classic 1836, and the results have dramatically changed. But these are real similar. This is an 1801, this is an 1836. The difference being I'm getting more of the phosphorus value in this product. And I think that's something my yard really needs here. It's what my soil needs, because it's usually a nutrient that's usually lacking here is phosphorus. And so that helps with the root development and stuff. In that video, I said, you know, we can get in this debate about, you know, you're not applying it correctly. So here it says to apply 12 to 18 ounces per thousand square foot every 4 to 8 weeks, okay? So every 4 to 8 weeks. So if I apply 12 to 18 ounces, we'll do the math. I'll step you through this math again, but we've already concluded that 18 ounces is going to give us a quarter pound of nitrogen per thousand, but I'll step you through it on this one. So again, look on the label here. It tells you how much a gallon weighs, and that's going to be 10.5 pounds, okay? So 10.5 pounds in 1 gallon, going to multiply that times 0.18, that's your end value, is 1.89 pounds. We've got to get pounds down to, or pounds per 1 gallon, we've got to get that down to ounces. So you're going to take 1.89, divide that by 128 ounces, which gives you 0.01476 pounds per ounce. So that's 1 ounce. So 0.01476 times 12 ounces, because it says apply 12 ounces per thousand. That gives you 0.78, which is real close, an eighth of a pound at 0.125 per thousand, okay? So it's a little more than an eighth of a pound of nitrogen per thousand. And it says up to 18 ounces per thousand. So 18 ounces per thousand is going to give us 0.26. So it's just slightly higher than 0.25 to give us a quarter pound of nitrogen per thousand square feet. So there's the math, folks. This is why I told you in the last video we could get in this debate about, well, you're not putting the right amount of product in your tank. I am. There's the math to show you why. And so John Perry's philosophy, and I'm not trying to misspeak for him, but I really think what he's all about is less inputs with long-term results. So meaning, you know, he likes to do low inputs over time to increase, you know, your nutrition in your lawn. And that's why they have the different products and the different variations that they have. And that just, for whatever reason, it just doesn't work well for me here, because I think it's because it's so hot. We're over 100 degrees here in July, and I've got kind of a clay soil here. I've got a lot of factors that are different for us than what's like for you guys in different parts of the U.S., and that's why I just don't think that works well for me. But what I did figure out is a couple of things with this product. And first one is just an obvious thing. Whenever you open a bag of fertilizer, you know that smell, the chemical smell it has? These bags have that. You know you're getting nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. You can smell it. Same thing with the Classic 1836. This stuff has a really strong vapor, and you gotta wear a mask when you use it, because it'll knock you down. It'll burn your lungs. You can tell there's chemical in that. With the next product line, what I found is you don't really have that chemical smell. And what it is it's more of just a stinky water. And everything is real dark. You can see the product, it's real dark. It's brown, it stains your tanks. And I know it's got some more organic type things in it, but I feel like it's kind of lacking in the chemical world of products. And that's why I just don't think it gives you the results you would expect, because like I told you, I was putting down a quarter rate. I started out doing it every couple weeks, and then I went down to doing a quarter rate every week, trying to get more results out of this. And what would happen is it would green up, and I would mow, and everything would start to just kind of yellow out and not ever really hold its punch. And that just isn't normal for my yard. I've done this for a lot of years, spraying liquid, and it just wasn't working for me. All that to say, the thing I finally figured out about the next product line, and I think this is important, they have a really big problem with the product sticks to this jug. And so it says shake well. They all say shake well. But look at this, okay? Nothing sticking to the bottom of this tank, okay? So you can shake that up and it's ready to go just like anything else. This stuff, you can see how dark the bottom of that tank is. So what I have found is when I shake this up, it mixes up the water, but there's still a bunch of sludge down on the bottom of the tank. I found that out when I poured the 1 gallon jugs into this big 2.5 gallon jug. They've got a real problem with, I think, a lot of their nutrition and the things that are important inside of this mix is stuck to the bottom of the jug. And so the only way I was able to get that is, yeah, shake it well, but turn it upside down for a good while and let it fall off the bottom of the tank and shake it up again. Then it changed the smell of it. And I know that sounds weird, but it made a difference. And so I think that's why the next product is just not as effective for me, because they've got a real problem with that stuff sticking into your tanks and your spray tank and stuff like that. So I don't know what that's all about. I don't know chemistry, but just applying some common sense to how things smell, how things act, like when you shake them up, that's why I've concluded what I concluded about the next product line. And so for me, I'm just not that interested in it for fertilizer. It's just not going to be what I'm going to go with. I really like this product. It's formulated for golf courses. They have the different rates for greens, fairways, and tees. Because it has that slow-release nitrogen in it, it just makes a very long-lasting result for my yard. It stays deep green, dark green all season long, even through the West Texas heat when it's 100-plus degrees. We stay green, and it looks good all the time. So that's it, guys. I mean, that's why this stuff is the way it is. There's some of the math. There's some of the reasons why. I wish I would have known this stuff a long time ago, because now it all makes sense. It's easy to do. And you might ask, you know, why did I do the math the way I did it? Because others out there, you've got to multiply it by 1,000, divide by 1,000, all this crazy stuff. Well, that's why I use the value of 100, because then you don't have to do all the conversion. And so just that little simplification can make all the math a whole lot easier. I know this is going to be a little harder to follow, but hopefully with me putting the math up here on the screen, you guys can kind of follow along and take your time with it and understand what it is you're doing. And hopefully you'll have great results with your lawn. You'll be able to understand how much fertilizer you're putting down, how much nitrogen you're putting down. Because believe me, when you learn that trick, it's the game changer. That's when everything changes for you, is when you understand the math and the fertilizer. That's how you get the results that everybody's going to be jealous of in your neighborhood. Guys, I hope that all this information is helpful. You know, I know that's a long math lesson. It's a lot of talking. If you've stuck with me this far, thank you. I hope you've learned something. You know, if you guys have questions after this with the math or you need help figuring something out, please drop me a comment. I'll help you figure out whatever product you're looking at. And so if you guys haven't already, please like this video and subscribe to our channel. But I think that's going to do it for this one, guys. We'll see you in the next one.